Okay, so Nimish, let's start your mock for Gas Authority of India Limited. So please introduce yourself to us.
Okay, sir. So, sir, I am Nimish Vagve. I am proper from Lanza village, Ratnagiri district, Maharashtra. My district Ratnagiri is in news now due to heavy rain and heavy flood in our area and large landslide in our area. Okay, and I completed my education up to 12th in my junior college, my school and junior college. And then after, based on CET marks, I got admission to Vishwakarma Institute of Technology, Pune for chemical engineering. And as I want to go to PSU, I gave my grade in my final year and I have secured All India rank 23 in my first attempt only. And I will like to add one thing. And my BTech completed in June. And as I was free in July, to keep my learning continue, I did one internship in Rashtriya Chemical and Fertilizers Limited, Thal plant, which is also customer of GAIL for natural gas.
Okay. So can you tell me other customers of GAIL, of natural gas?
Kripco is also a major customer of GAIL for natural gas. And most of the fertilizer companies are the major customers.
So, what is the role of natural gas in fertilizer?
Sir, for synthesis of ammonia in fertilizer companies, there is synthesis of ammonia.
Mm-hmm.
For ammonia synthesis, we require hydrogen, mm-hmm. and with hydrogen, this comes from this natural gas. We are doing reforming of natural gas to produce hydrogen.
So Nimish, tell me how GAIL supplies natural gas to Rashtriya Chemical Fertilizer plants.
Sir, it is from underground pipelines, and I think it is coming from Mumbai. I don't know exactly, but many of the road pe jo symbols lage rehte GAIL ke, I have seen that, and it is written GAIL Mumbai. I think it is coming from Mumbai.
Okay. So can you tell me, agar mere ko 1,000 kilometer pipeline lagani hai GAIL mein, to main pumping power kaise calculate karunga?
Sir, for GAIL it is transferring gas. So we want to use a compressor instead of pump. Are you talking about liquid?
Yes, I am talking about a gas only. Compressor power means pumping power. Pump करना है गैस को.
Yes.
Press करना है. Supply करना है.
Yes. For gas, I don't know about gas. How to calculate for pumping power and compression power for gas.
Okay, Nimish, tell me who is the CMD of GAIL?
Which chairman and are you talking about chairman?
Yeah, chairman.
Yes, chairman of the GAIL is Honorable Manoj Jain.
Which is what is his background?
I think he is mechanical engineer and he has done MBA also.
Okay.
And he is working for 34 years in GAIL. That's only I know.
Achha, have you heard about telecom part of GAIL? GAIL is in telecommunication also?
Yes, GAIL also provide telecommunication. GAIL,
yeah, but don't you find telecom activity and energy activity totally diametrically opposite?
I don't know how GAIL network, but I think that as GAIL have very long pipeline, it is easier for them to transport landline wires also. Easier for them. That's why GAIL have developed. It is my thought. I don't know how.
Which wires you are talking about?
Optical fiber.
Optical fiber. So what is the benefit of that? अच्छा गैस स्टेशन आपको पता है गेल के गैस स्टेशंस भी हैं?
गैस प्रोसेसिंग यूनिट और
गैस सेलिंग स्टेशंस. ये जो पेट्रोल पंप होता है,
yes.
तो वैसे ये जो ऑटोज में आपका सीएनजी भरा जाता है, कंप्रेस्ड नेचुरल गैस, ऑटो चलता है ना सीएनजी के ऊपर?
यस यस सर।
दिल्ली के अंदर भी सीएनजी है सारा?
ये
सीएनजी कौन से पेट्रोल पंप, जैसे पेट्रोल पंप है सीएनजी के लिए कहाँ भरा जाता है ये सारा?
I have heard that in Delhi there are 9 gas gas power stations.
आपने देखा है सीएनजी जो है वो IOCL के पेट्रोल पंप पे भी मिलता है? Have you seen that? पेट्रोल पंप पे गैस भी भरी जाती है, any idea?
No sir.
No idea? तो गैस कहाँ भरते हैं सीएनजी वाली?
Sir, in our village there is one pump which is distributing CNG. That I have heard only about it.
But you know na, Delhi में सारा public transportation CNG based है? You know that?
Yes, I have read it somewhere, but I haven't proper idea about it.
Okay. अच्छा निमिष, tell me why you are interested in GAIL?
Sir, GAIL is promote performance oriented work. Means this will help me to maintain balance between my daily life and work. Also, I have done internship in a heavy water plant of RCA, which is designed by DAE, Department of Atomic Energy. They have designed in such a way that it is making more efficient process. And in GAIL company is also expanding company. Now this is expanding in biogas. I think I can use this my knowledge in a expansion of GAIL, in a designing of GAIL components. I can't get such an opportunity in any other place. So that's why I want to join GAIL. And another some reasons are, it is as a Maharatna company, it will provide financial safety and job safety. Means if you give me chance to work with GAIL, I do not want to think about money. I can focus completely on my work. I can completely do my work, focus on it, instead of thinking about money and job safety. That's why I am thinking to join GAIL.
No, but then there are other public sectors also. You may get other public sector also.
Sir, GAIL provide a somewhat different work profile. And I have also heard from my seniors that GAIL is also a challenging work task and supportive job environment. This is GAIL provide. And this will help me to grow professionally. As compared to other PhDs.
Achha, if I ask you, you are selected in GAIL today. So what, after 10 years, which role do you see for yourself in GAIL?
In GAIL, I am thinking that I know each and every process going on in GAIL in detail. And if there is any problem, I can easily handle this problem in GAIL. And during startup and shutdown, there are many accidents in any company. Any chemical company. If I am 10 years in GAIL, there is no single accident during startup and shutdown. This is what I will see after 10 years.
लेकिन ये तो तुम्हें 5 साल में पता लग जाएगा सारी चीज. ये लर्निंग जो तुम बताया, that you can learn in 5 years itself. 5 साल बहुत ज्यादा टेन्योर होता है, right?
Yes.
So what after 5 years then?
After 5 years, I will try to make the process efficient. If we are losing a single energy, if we are losing energy anywhere, I will see. I will try to use this energy. There is no loss of energy. And also, GAIL is now expanding in biofuel. I am seeing my contribution in this. Expanding biofuel energy.
Okay, Nikhil sir, sir, over to you.
Okay. Okay, Nimish sir, tell me about your project.
Sir, I have done one project in aluminium removal from water using adsorption.
What kind of adsorbent you have used?
Activated alumina.
Activated alumina?
Yes.
So you have prepared this adsorbent or you have used...
We are thinking to do an experiment in lab. But we taken this project in February, in December, where the corona is very less. And we are thinking to perform experiment in lab. But as the corona pandemic increases later in March, we could not get anything to do with lab. We only literature survey, like studying 15 to 20 adsorbents and finding best adsorbents of them. And they are doing some MATLAB programming.
Why alumina adsorbent?
We studied 18 adsorbents total, and in this activated alumina is found to be have most more capacity, 1.8 milligram aluminum removal per gram of water.
Apart from alumina adsorbent, what kind of other adsorbent you have studied?
Activated carbon is this. Activated carbon, rice husk, and other.
How to prepare adsorbent from rice husk?
Rice husk. Okay. Rice husk. I don't know exactly how to prepare.
Don't know. Okay, you have said there is a future for biofuels. What are the different types of biofuels, you know?
Sir, I only know biogas, which is we are using in our home. I know only about
biogas or kuch?
No.
Okay. Okay, you did your internship recently, isn't it? So tell me about your internship. What did you learn there?
Sir, I want to work on heavy water plant. In RCF, there is heavy water plant. I was training on heavy water plant. Owner is Department of Atomic Energy.
Okay.
I want to learn how they are extracting deuterium from the synthesis gas. Synthesis gas here is N2 plus H2. And deuterium is as the isotope of hydrogen, it always somewhat come with H2. So we want to, and in a synthesis gas, it is at 100 to 108 ppm, which is a very small quantity of deuterium in synthesis gas. And we want to extract this deuterium by number of unit operations. And finally, per day, there is production of 300 liters of deuterium, D2O, heavy water. This is the whole process I want to study in this area.
You have studied there.
Yes.
Okay. So why the steam reforming reaction is done? What is the reason behind that?
Are you talking about this ammonia unit, ammonia plant?
Steam reforming.
So it is done in ammonia plant. I only know that they are using CH4 to convert CO and H2.
Okay.
I don't know. We are not allowed to go to ammonia plant and other urea.
So what are the different techniques you know for hydrogen production?
Which what production, sir?
Hydrogen.
Hydrogen. Okay. Sir, recently RCF is also working on this coal gasification.
Okay. Good.
In which coal is distributing.
That is one method.
Yes.
Other methods?
Other I don't know. Only two methods. One from natural gas and other from coal gasification. That's only two.
What is that called? From natural gas? That method is called as reforming.
Yes. They are using reforming.
There is one more method.
I don't know about.
Okay, what are the different impurities in the synthesis gas?
Synthesis gas, one impurity is sulfur. Natural gas, it is a sulfur as an impurity. It is after natural gas comes to RCF, it is first get removed. Sulfur is removed.
What are the different sulfurous compound as impurities?
It is available as sulfur. I don't know exactly.
What about the nitrogenous compound?
NOx, some is NOx, NO or NO2. This is available in very small quantity.
Yes, that is available in very small quantity. What is the major part of nitrogenous impurities in synthesis gas?
I don't know.
Okay, no problem. What is the significance of mass transfer coefficient?
Mass transfer coefficient is how our packing or any column is efficient. Means how it is efficient for doing mass transfer. By using mass transfer coefficient, we can easily calculate rate of mass transfer in a molar flux and this kind of quantity.
Okay. What is overall mass transfer coefficient? Why overall mass transfer coefficient is required?
Sir, individual mass transfer coefficient is calculated at interface. We are assuming interface between two phases, and by this way we are calculating individual mass transfer coefficient. But actually practicing measuring concentration at interface is not possible.
Okay.
So we are using overall mass transfer coefficient.
Okay. What is the significance of thermal diffusion?
Thermal diffusion. Thermal diffusivity is K by rho Cp. Thermal diffusivity is K by rho Cp. It gives us if for any fluid, how much heat is transferred as compared to how much heat is stored.
Okay. So, what happens when thermal diffusivity value is very high? What is the meaning of that?
It transfers fluid very easily from one place to another.
Fluid.
Heat. It transfers heat more efficiently from one point to another instead of storing inside it.
Okay. Okay. Why insulations are required? You have seen different kind of insulation of on different kind of equipments on plants.
Yes.
So why insulation? We do insulation.
Sir, let us take example. If you want to transfer a steam from one point to another, and if we are not providing insulation to it, then due to a surrounding, there is maybe much more steam will get condensed. Means due to heat transfer from a steam pipe to surrounding, much more much steam get condensed, which is not means we are losing energy, and that's why we are providing insulation. Means general talking, to save our energy from transferring to surrounding, we are using insulation.
Okay, good. What is viscosity?
Viscosity gives us internal resistance of fluid to flow. Means if more the viscosity of any fluid, then it will slowly flow on the surface, inclined surface. Less the viscosity have, it will easily can flow on the surface.
What is the variation of viscosity with respect to temperature?
Sir, are you talking about gas or liquid?
Both. Explain me about both the cases.
For liquid, viscosity decreases with temperature. And for gas, viscosity increases with temperature.
Why?
Yes. For a liquid, the viscosity is due to cohesive forces. Means forces between the molecules.
Similar kind of molecules. Okay.
Yes. And if we increase temperature, this molecule getting going away and away, and that's why its viscosity decreases. But for in case of gas, the viscosity is due to molecular momentum.
Okay.
As temperature increases, gas molecules try to collide with each other.
Okay.
And that's how the viscosity in gas.
Okay, good. Okay. What is incompressible fluid?
Incompressible fluid whose density does not change with application of pressure.
And what is incompressible flow?
Incompressible flow.
Yes.
So what
is there any difference between incompressible fluid and incompressible flow?
Incompressible fluid is the fluid whose their density does not change, and in incompressible flow, if we measure density at this point, we are applying pressure at this point for flow. The density always same at each and every point. There is no change in density during flow. This is called incompressible flow.
So, and is it the flow of incompressible fluid is always incompressible?
If we are changing applying large pressure, then there is small change in density of fluid.
Okay, so bol sakte hain ya nahi bol sakte?
Not it We're not all fluids, all liquids we can say it is incompressible. Gas are generally compressible.
Is the flow of compressible fluid is always compressible?
No, I don't think so.
Why?
Because different fluid have a different density. Mm-hmm. While talking about some water and such kind of very less compressible fluid,
mm-hmm.
less incompressible fluid, mm-hmm. their viscosity, their density does not change by the fluid. We can assume it is incompressible flow. But I don't know about another fluid. I don't know about any other fluid.
Okay, sir, I'm done from my side.
Okay, Nikhil sir, please go ahead and give your feedback.
Okay, Nimish, पहले तो आप अपना प्रोजेक्ट के बारे में अच्छे से पढ़िए, क्योंकि आप प्रोजेक्ट में बहुत, आपको मैंने स्टार्टिंग में बोला था जब आपने ये मॉड्यूल लिया था कि प्रोजेक्ट और इंटर्नशिप के बारे में समरी एक एक पेज का लिख के रखे, बोल आप दो लाइन ही बोल पा रहे हैं इसके बारे में, एडजॉइनमेंट के बारे में, और उसके बारे में अच्छे से आपको नॉलेज नहीं है. ठीक है, आपने बोला कि ये एडजॉइनमेंट में हम लोगों ने स्टडी किया, पर वो कैसे एडजॉइनमेंट बन रहा राइस आपको नहीं पता रहेगा, तो क्रॉस क्वेश्चन होगा वो, क्योंकि वो आपका काम है. ठीक है, आपका पर्सनल काम है और वो आप बता नहीं पा रहे, बाकी तो जो क्वेश्चन वहाँ पूछा जाएगा वो तो उसको अलग कर देते हैं हम लोग. ठीक है, जो आपने किया है उसके ऊपर पहले क्वेश्चन आएगा. ठीक है ना, और अगर वो आप अगर डिफेंड नहीं कर पाएंगे तो दिक्कत हो जाएगा, तो इसको डिफेंड करना बहुत जरूरी है जो आपने किया है. आपका प्रोजेक्ट और इंटर्नशिप बहुत डिपेंड करता है, क्योंकि उसी में आपका इंटरव्यू खत्म हो सकता है, बाकी क्वेश्चन पूछेगा ही नहीं कोई आपसे, क्योंकि आपने रिसेंटली इंटर्नशिप किया है और प्रोजेक्ट भी आपने दिस ईयर ही आपने पास आउट है ना, तो प्रोजेक्ट भी आपने रिसेंटली किया है. ठीक है, तो ये दो तो बहुत बड़ा फैक्टर है, आप इसके बारे में अच्छे से प्रिपेयर रहिए आप, क्योंकि यहाँ पर मिस नहीं होना चाहिए. और आंसर देने का टाइम आप बहुत सारा टू मच इन्फॉर्मेशन दे रहे हैं जो रिक्वायर्ड नहीं है. ठीक है, जैसे आपने बायोफ्यूल बता दिया आंसर में कहीं पर आपको पता नहीं बायोफ्यूल क्या क्या होता है. बायोडीजल एक तो बायोफ्यूल होता है, बायोगैस होता है, इथेनॉल होता है. ठीक है, ये तीन प्रकार का बायोफ्यूल होता है ना ये सब. और फिर हाइड्रोजन प्रोडक्शन कैसे कैसे होता है, गैसिफिकेशन एक होता है, रिफॉर्मिंग द सेकंड पार्ट, एंड थर्ड पार्ट इज इलेक्ट्रोलिसिस. हम लोग वाटर का इलेक्ट्रोलिसिस करके हाइड्रोजन प्रोडक्शन कर सकते हैं ना.
यस,
है कि नहीं.
यस,
इंप्योरिटीज क्या क्या रहता है सिंथेसिस गैस, सल्फर कंपाउंड्स दैट इज हाइड्रोजन सल्फाइड एंड सल्फर कार्बोनिल, नाइट्रोजिनस कंपाउंड्स दैट इज मोस्टली अमोनिया, ओके, और हाइड्रोजन सियानाइड. ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड रहेगा आपका नाइट्रोजनस इंप्योरिटीज आर अमोनिया NH3.
अच्छा, हाउ इट कैन बी इंप्योरिटी,
इट इज NH3. सिंथेसिस गैस इज द मेन रीजन फॉर सिंथेसिस गैस इज टू प्रोड्यूस हाइड्रोजन ओनली, अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट ऑल आर इंप्योरिटीज. इंप्योरिटीज आपका कैसे हम लोग कैलकुलेट करते हैं, हम लोग का जो सेलेक्टिविटी के ऊपर में होता है ना इंप्योरिटीज. आपका यहाँ पर हम लोग फर्टिलाइजर्स में ना प्रोडक्शन कर रहे हैं, हम लोग हाइड्रोजन प्रोडक्शन कर रहे हैं. सिंथेसिस गैस का जो मेन मोटर रहता है वो हाइड्रोजन प्रोडक्शन कर रहता है, बाकी जो भी आपका साइड रिएक्शन हो रहा है, साइड प्रोडक्शन हो रहा है, वो आपका प्रोड्यूस नहीं है, वो यील्ड नहीं है, वो इंप्योरिटीज है ना. हम लोग केमिकल रिएक्शन में कैसे करते हैं, जो बाय प्रोडक्ट आता है उसको हम लोग प्रोडक्ट मानते हैं क्या, नहीं ना मानते हैं, समझ रहे हो. यहाँ से जो NH3 निकला उसको फिर हम लोग को सेपरेट करने के लिए हम लोग फिर अलग केमिकल सेपरेशन प्रोसेस करेंगे, वो अलग है. पर अभी जो इम्प्योरिटी जो सिंथेसिस गैस का जो मेन मोटो है हाइड्रोजन प्रोडक्शन, वहां पर जो कुछ भी साइड रिएक्शन हो रहा है वो इम्प्योरिटीज ही मानेंगे हम, समझ रहे हैं.
यस सर,
ऑयल इंडस्ट्री में जो सल्फर प्रोडक्शन होता है वो इम्प्योरिटीज है, पर सल्फ्यूरिक एसिड प्रोडक्शन के लिए सल्फर इम्प्योरिटीज नहीं है, वो फीडस्टॉक है उसका.
yes,
समझ रहे हैं, तो
yes.
वो अलग अलग चीज है, हर चीज का मतलब अलग होता है फीडस्टॉक प्रोडक्ट, वो डिपेंड करता है आप क्या चीज प्रोड्यूस कर रहे हैं, क्या चीज आप ले रहे हैं. ठीक है,
ये
और बाकी सही है. हाँ, ये आपका इनकम्प्रेसिबल फ्लूइड क्या होता है, जिसका डेंसिटी वेरिएशन नहीं होता विद एप्लीकेशन ऑफ प्रेशर. ठीक है, और इनकम्प्रेसिबल फ्लूइड का फ्लो हमेशा इनकम्प्रेसिबल रहता है, क्योंकि वो डेंसिटी चेंज नहीं होगा विद द कोर्स ऑफ फ्लो, कभी नहीं चेंज होगा. बहुत हाई अमाउंट ऑफ प्रेशर देंगे तब कुछ परसेंटेज जब चेंज होगा, नहीं तो नहीं चेंज होगा. और आपका कंप्रेसिबल फ्लूइड जो है वो कब होता है, मैक नंबर इज व्हेन द मैक नंबर इज 1/3.33, वहां तक उससे कम अगर रहेगा तो उसका फ्लो हमेशा इनकम्प्रेसिबल लगा, क्योंकि वहाँ डेंसिटी चेंज वेरिएशन बहुत कम हो रहा है. ठीक है, अगर डेंसिटी वेरिएशन विद द कोर्स ऑफ फ्लो is very negligible, then we can say incompressible flow, whether it is compressible fluid or incompressible fluid.
Yes.
Okay. और इंसुलेशन का आपने सही बताया, एबेरेशन और विस्कोसिटी सही है आपका, ठीक है बाकी लेकिन जो भी है कॉन्फिडेंटली आप आंसर दीजिए और ये पहला दो चीज को अच्छे से आप ये स्टडी करिए अपना प्रोजेक्ट को इंटर्न को, ठीक है क्योंकि आपके पास टाइम बहुत कम है और आपका ये सिनगेस आपने बोल रहे हैं पर सिनगेस का मेन मोटो क्या होता है वो सोचिए, हाइड्रोजन प्रोडक्शन इसका मेन मोटो होता है, ठीक है तो ये सब पढ़िए ये सब अच्छे से, ठीक है कॉन्फिडेंटली आंसर दीजिए दिया करिए और बहुत सारा टू मच इन्फॉर्मेशन मत दीजिए अपने आंसर, ठीक है
आइए
ओके
ओके सो निमिष यू नो इंट्रोडक्शन आपका बहुत लंबा था, इवन माय फीडबैक इज दैट के यू गिव लॉट ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन इन इंट्रोडक्शन, ट्राई टू सिमुलेट एवरीथिंग विद इन 1.5 to 2 minutes, डोंट गिव इंफॉर्मेशन अबाउट योर मार्क्स स्कूल मार्क्स एंड ऑल दीज डिटेल्स आर नॉट रिक्वायर्ड, वेरी ब्रीफली यू हैव टू मेंटेन from where you are, what your parents are doing, from where you did your schooling, little bit place and your graduation, when did you graduate, and then you may come over to the most interesting part, maybe your project or maybe your hobbies or maybe why you want to join. So anything you should say so that next question is predicted, right?
Yeah.
That has to be HR part. And then you have done your training in RCFL, so I'm very sure they're going to ask you some questions because yes, that is one of the customer of GAIL. RCFL along with the National Fertilizer Limited NFL, so through gas pipeline they supply it. So then you were talking about when I asked you why GAIL, so your answer was very vague, you were telling a lot of things actually. You need to be very straight, sir. GAIL is a reputed organization and a prestigious public sector, and this is the best job anybody can get, good salary, stable job, and balanced lifestyle, personal professional lifestyle. So that is the answer, typical answer which I was expecting, you know, for why GAIL. And rest, I think, go through the website of GAIL and also listen to the other snaps I've done for GAIL of other students, because I've asked many questions in that. This is how it is to be done. So your overall feedback from my side is like you are taking a lot of sentences to give answer to particular question, which otherwise is very straight, right?
Yeah.
This is how you have to prepare. Anything you want to ask?
When
is your interview?
2nd August.
August. Chalo, prepare well. If you feel like asking anything, you can call us, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, Nimish, all the very best for your exam. Interview.
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank
all the best to Nimish and please call me tomorrow, okay?
Yes, sir.
ठीक है हमसे बात कर लेना कब कल आप आपसे बात करना है ठीक है
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Thank you.